Live from Montauk, New York, it's the Friday Night Hustle, starring Nancy Atlas. Nancy's guests tonight include, well, special guests. So sit back and enjoy yourself in your quarantine fantasy land. I'm Johnny Blood, and enough of my rambling. Here's Nancy Atlas.
It's a Friday night hustle, everybody. Friday night. Cheers to you. Yellow Richard, hello. Oh no. Or even try to school ya. Oh no. Waiting for everybody to come on in. Just a minute or two, come on. How's everybody doing? Could you be love? Come on. Could be love. Mama son. What's going up? Chris and Rob. Lady McCoy. Hey, Sharon. Hi, everyone. Debbie, I can't wait to hear what you made tonight. Hey, hey, Nipple Queens in the house. What's going on, Lady Eaton? Oh, we got Lynn from Florida, Hula Hut Spirits. Right on. Come on. Hi, Bridget. Oh, we're going to have your beautiful daughter tonight's going to be playing. What's going on, McCoy? Oh, no. Well, let me tell you something. We have a show for you tonight. Oh, my gosh. I got to get going because I can't wait. I can't do my regular 9-minute role of drinking and saying hello to everyone. Hi, Chip. Hi, Nancy. Very nice name, Nancy. I will always say that. Georgia Wonder, we're going to heal your single mind. All right. Wow, it goes out of tune so quick. Maybe it's just me. Maybe I just don't know how to keep a guitar in tune. You know what's enjoyable? Having an outfit for your reggae night that has green in it and starting your broadcast and realizing, and hold on, let's see if I can get totally invisible. Hold on, which way does it go? I'm turning into a ghost. Hold on. There I am. I'm going to have to take it off. I have my red, yellow, and my green, and a little bit of black, too. I was right there. Hey, Jay. How you doing? Happy Friday night, my friend. I thought I'd start out with just a little appropriate. You can sing along with me. You know this one. Come on, take a sip of that drink, seltzer or rum punch. Sing, it's good for you. Don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be alright. Sing and don't worry about a thing. Every little thing is gonna be alright. Rise up this morning, smiled at the rising sun. Three little birds by my doorstep, singing sweet songs. night, everybody. Singing, don't worry about a thing. Cause every little thing is gonna be alright. Singing, don't worry about a thing. Cause every little thing is gonna be alright. Should I do one more round? This is my message to you. Yeah, man. You know, up and down, round and round we go. We are at week 10. Let me shut this all. Hold on. We are at week 10 or something like that. Can we give ourselves a round of applause? We're like 3 months in already. And because I have a dress under here, I actually shaved my armpits, which is very exciting for everyone in this house. It's really, really good stuff. So let me just see who's here and let me just say hello. Oh. Is Winston in the house yet? I'm hoping he's going to check in with us today. All right, my camera seems to be working because I yelled at my entire family last week that they were streaming. And I just wanted to say that it's been cold out, which has been kind of a little bit of a twist to everything because we could just keep going here and we keep waiting for it to warm up. And the good news is that when it, you know, because it's cold, I guess it's still been a little bit easier to stay contained, I don't know. But the warm weather is coming, and when it does come, we are going to be ready to lie out in our backyards and soak that sunshine in. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to start the night with my good friend, because you can't have Jamaica and reggae night without a little bit of love from Winston Iree. This was taken from a show at the Talk House with Mama Lee, Rose, and I singing some backup. I think Inda's there. Too. It's hard to tell. The footage was taken by Carol King. Thank you, Carol. And Telly's on harmonica to boot. Here's a little trip down memory lane.
For all the things you have done for me.
know, I have to say, I love me some reggae. I do. Oh! And there is green on my dress as well. I'm just a ghost tonight. Woo! So let me tell you a story that I know about reggae. Okay, this is a true story. Some of you that do not know who I am, and that might be just checking in from this phenomenal article that was just done by my incredible friend Queenie, aka Bridget LeRoy. I am a band leader and have been a band leader for 25 years. And a very large part of my early career as a band was playing Friday and Saturday nights at the Stephen Talk House. So let me repeat that. I would play Friday and Saturday night from 10 p.m. often until 4. I would typically leave there at 4:30 in the morning. Often, I would get home between 5. If I was living in Southampton at the time, I'd get home 5:30. It was amazing, amazing period. So we would play back to back. So we'd play Friday night, 10 to 3:30, 4 o'clock, whatever, and then go to sleep, wake up waitress, and then I'd play Saturday, 10 p.m. to 3 or 4. Within those parameters, I have seen things that I could probably write a pretty, I could give Elton John a run for his money on his book. But one of the number one rules that I learned from that time was that whenever there was a fist fight, if you started playing reggae, it would calm everything down. And I mean, I've seen people lose teeth. I've seen brawls. I've seen a lot of shit, people. Anyway, reggae solves it all. Reggae solves it all. And so often if I see a guy that's like getting a little aggressive, even a little out of sorts, he will go from like literally like this to like, hey, I love you. I love you. What were we fighting about? Oh my gosh, Carl's, how you doing, baby? How you feeling? Yvette, I hope I'm saying your name right. I do not know what those plants are, but there is a very strong possibility that they are pot plants. There's a very, 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 very strong possibility. All right, so listen, people, we got a big show for you tonight. I have a lot of food in the house. I think I'm going to start it off with corn nuts because nothing says East End reggae like Indy Eaton making some corn nuts, teaching us how to make some corn nuts.
Hello, Nancy Atlas. Nancy Atlas Show. Our friends in the East, our friends in the West. My name is Inda Eaton, and today I'm doing a PSA. That's a public service announcement sponsored by Shelter in Place Album. Today, we're going to teach the children, we're going to teach each other how to make corn nuts. I'm going to be using corn oil, very simple corn oil. We're going to be using the hominy corn that was prepared earlier. Basically, the recipe for corn nuts is that you boil the corn in oil. Camera. Right now, you hear almost like this jet engine airplane. That's just the oil cooking up. We're gonna wait for the oil to cook up and then we're gonna add the corn. The process of making corn nuts, it takes a bit of time. And I think we could all agree that the sleepy time tea does help. When making corn nuts, and it's crazy because it's not really a nut, it's corn. You have to ask yourself, when do I put it in the oil? Today, we do not have a specific thermometer, so I'm just gonna do the old test. Yeah. I'm gonna add these nice corn pieces in here. Earlier, before we just put the corn in the boiling oil, I did simmer it for about 45 minutes, kind of lid half closed, and then I dried it out in the pilot light of the oven. You don't have to do that, but I think it makes a better product. And honest to God, if you don't do that, you're going to have to go take an emergency dentist appointment. We are getting very close. We will now take these corn kernels, which are now transformed into nuts. This is a pre-rapture shopping bag, all right? Meaning, I would have thunk 2 months ago we'd be making corn nuts in the backyard on a Thursday. I mean, it's a little bit much. In the end, this is a corn nut. We've gone from maïs, I guess that's what they say, maïs, hominy, and we've made corn nuts like that at the gas station. So Nancy Atlas Show, our good people, thank you for tuning in. This has been a PSA from Shelter in Place album. My name is Inda Eaton. Peace.
You know, I have to say, I'm going to watch that shit again. I want me some of those. And you know what else doesn't say? You know what? You know what says Jamaica to me? Inda Eaton making corn nuts and Nancy Atlas eating some guacamole. Because I've been in my studio all day for this fucking show. So while you're all eating jerk chicken and like vegetarian Jamaican food, I got like enough time to mash that's green too. My entire life is green. Look at this. Everything's green today. Yes, I have a green screen on. No, I'm not in a tropical lush forest. I'm in a fucking cold basement in Montauk right now. You'd never know it. Ooh, I am so going to get me some hominy corn. I think what that is that is the corn that they have in the freezer department that's in big bags of corn and that you get, I think they make tortillas out of it. Excuse me. Oh my God, I just coughed. Stop the presses, I just coughed. You know, I thought about that. We talked about that last time on one of the things is that, you know, in the plague, you may not know this, but the first sign of the plague was a sneeze. And so when you sneezed in 1482, they would say, God bless you. And now, here we are in 2020 and you cough. And instead of God bless you, they say, cover your fucking mouth. Ah, what 400 years have done. We've progressed. So instead we're saying, are you okay? God bless you. We say, get the fuck out of here. Anyway. we've really evolved as a civilization, I think. We have a little bit of a rally. We're up to 14. Let's see if we can get those likes up to 20. The likes honestly get me off a little bit. I don't know why, but they do. I've turned into one of those people. I think I'm 14. I don't know. Oh, we're up to 19. I'll tell you what. If we get the likes up to 26, I'll play Clam Lady. Come on, baby. Get the 23. What else do you got? What do you got? 23. I don't see shit now. It's stuck at 23. Oh, we're at 31. We're at 31. You know what that means. Hold on, Bob. Hold on. This is a very special clam lady to my heart. So it's been 2 weeks, and she's our favorite second tier East End. She's been needing a little bit of help lately. But it turns out that it's very weird about this show is that I either have a video of live music with my band or Clam Lady appears. It's almost as if the two cannot happen in the same week. I don't know. That's very, I want to say Bruce Weber, but that's the photographer. What's his name? That's Batman. I wonder who Clam Lady really is. I wonder.
Hi everyone, Ryan Williams here. You may notice that I look a little crazy with this shaved eyebrow. The reason I did it? Well, why the hell not? It's been a hectic 10 weeks since the pandemic really cracked wide open. Let's check on everyone's favorite East End superhero, Clam Lady. Clam Lady, I've missed you. How are you doing?
Ryan Williams, it is so good to hear your voice. I hope you're safe. It's Clam Lady here, your second tier East End superhero. I'm just trying to cover my arm a little bit because I can't find my other black sleeve. And Seagull Boy took my other silver cuff. That bastard chewed it right in front of me when he didn't get the job last week. But it's all right. My mask ripped, but I got my magic tape. It's all relative, right? It's all relative. We're here in a beautiful part of Long Island, and I'm, you know, I know what to be thankful for.
Anything new going on that we should know about on the East End?
Well, thank you for asking that, Ryan, because nobody can do it alone. So I have been working with the businesses out here on the East End to implement a bouncer program just to make sure that the protocol and the kindness and, you know, you and civility is maintained as we open for business here. You know, we have low numbers on the East End. We want to try to keep those numbers low with a smile on our face under our mask, if you catch what I'm saying. So anyway, I want to introduce you to some of the bouncers that you will be seeing this summer, and one or two that are interviewing. So here we go. Roll the tape.
Yo, I'm Phil Berg, and I'm the new bouncer at the IGA. You mess with the girls, you mess with me.
Any of you crackheads get out of line, I'm taking you out.
Hey, Clam Lady, I'm the bouncer here. You want to see this sunset, you got to get past me.
Hey, here at Hooked Montauk, we take our social distancing very seriously. Now, I don't want to have to break out my BB gun this summer and shoot your bike tire like a rabid baby squirrel, but I will if you don't stay 6 feet back from my mom and dad. You're going to learn real quick that redheaded girls, they have a straight shot.
Hi, I'm Cassius Muse. I'm 14 years old. I was looking for a job this summer. I was hoping to bus at the Harvest, but in these times, you can't really predict anything. So I'm hoping they give me a spot as a bouncer at Puff and Putt. You know, if you ever got a problem at hole number 3, you call me. I'll help you out.
Hey everyone, it's Shucker Girl. Clam Lady doesn't pay me enough, so I've been hoping for a job to be a bouncer for the Clam Bar this summer.
Hello, I am Sriracha Boy, and this summer I'll be bouncing here at El Taco Mexican Food. Be kind, be safe, or Sriracha will be in your eye. Sriracha, eye!
Hey, what's up, everybody? Seagull Boy here. Just a shout out to anybody that voted for me last week. But wow, what a shocker that Shucker Girl won, huh? Never saw that one coming. Whatever. The good news is that I did get a job, and I will be bouncing this summer at, can you even guess it? Ditch. That's right. I'm the fastest dog in the world. You cannot outrun me. And if you get out of line, I'm going to bite you in the ass. All right. You don't want a piece of these glasses. You know what I'm saying? I'm a total fool on top of that for the sesame noodles at the Ditch Witch. And don't even get me started about the tuna pokey, all right? So relax, it's gonna be a great summer, because you know why? Seagull Boy's got you back. You feel me?
Yo, listen up. This is Steven Sylvester from the Rum Punch Mafia there. And if you show up at the St. Therese Preschool, X4, prepare to see me. And make sure you have a smile on the MS. Rum Punch Mafia signing out.
Hey, Nancy Atlas, a singer-songwriter from the East End. I do have a lot of experience telling drunk men that I will snap them like thin, dry tampons. And so I have been called upon to bounce for the doc. That's right. You want your tune melt or those incredible muscles? You're going to have to get past me, bitch.
I'm sorry, Nancy, you're fired. George has hired me. Little Anthony here. I am the new bouncer at the Dock restaurant. Even though Mr. Watson makes fun of my partner, John, I am sorry. Nancy, you're fired.
You know what I'm sick of? I'm sick of hipsters. I'm sick of dusters. The clam lady, the cat lady, bicyclists, unicyclists, motorcyclists, hedge funders, slush funders. You know what else I'm sick of? I'm sick of coming down here every goddamn day and picking up dog shit, face masks, gloves, cigarette butts, Coney Island and Whitefish and garbage that people drop all over the place. I'm sick of everything. Oh, and by the way, we're opening on Thursday, May 21st. We'd like everyone to come down and have a good time.
Oh my goodness. Sorry, I have the reggae music. Here we go. Can I just say, anytime George Watson does something that I honestly just want him to be my friend, I think. I don't know what it is about that. Oh, thanks. A little flurry of likes on that one. A special thanks to Phil Berg, who sent that in from Arizona, to Cash, Levon and Tallulah, to Elise from the Montaukit, to everyone that was a part of that. So fun. I was really literally putting that together until like an hour before the show. So the funniest part about that movie is that in like 4 weeks from now, there will probably be East End bouncers at like Goldberg's. There just will. I don't know. You heard it here first, man. I'm on to something. I'm telling you. All right, listen. Let's make a little cocktail, don't you think? Little cocktail? No, you know what? I'm gonna do a quick hit with the heck is she? Where's my girl? All right. Yeah, we'll do a cocktail. Here we go. Here's from Lynn's Hula Hut, baby. Come on.
Aloha, everyone. Welcome to Lynn's Hula Hut in Montauk, the birthplace of Hula Hut spirits. I'm Lynn Calvo. Today, I'm going to make for you a spiced coconut mojito with the world-famous Hula Juice rum. This rum is famous all over Montauk and beyond. It's absolutely delicious. It's made from 100% American cane with spiced coconut and all natural. It's really, really yummy. So we're going to start by adding 2 ounces of the spiced coconut hula juice rum into a shaker. We've got the limes in here already. We're going to cut maybe 4 or 5 pieces of limes and muddle them with the rum. Okay. Then we're going to fill our glass, or a shaker actually, with ice. And then we're going to go over to our tropical chia pet and break up some fresh mint that came from our garden, which is actually very easy for you guys to grow at home. Just pick up a mint plant, especially if you like to entertain. It's just there for you and your guests right away. You don't have to worry about anything. Now we're going to shake it vigorously. Give it a really good shake. You know, You can't shake it enough to blend all the flavors. You never want to muddle the mint because you're going to bruise it. So here we go. We're going to fill our glass with ice. A little bit of ice. And you want to just put the shaken ingredients right into a tall glass with the mint. Then you're going to add a little bit of club soda. There you go. You can garnish it with a lime wheel. A nice fresh piece of lime. This is so refreshing. It's a big seller here at the Hula Hut. I cannot tell you how many of these we make every day. Thanks, guys. Cheers.
You know, I think the only, can we just do a play-by-play for real? Okay. No, let's be honest. Let's go there. Okay. So that was Lynn. And somehow, it's just a whole different bag of donuts. It's just a whole different bag of donuts. And yeah, I'm not being like sarcastic, like that. It's because I have chips and green guacamole, which is ghost guacamole because of my green screen. Ghost guacamole gonna get you on Halloween. All right. We're rolling along. You know what, Sweet Pea? I heard you, baby. Let's hit it. Let's do it, Sweet Pea. Let's do it.
All right, man. Tonight we are jamming. Got us a little reef going. Got us a good rumble box originally from Jamaica. Tonight we're going to do a little scalloped Jamaican style, Caribbean style. And we're going to do a little fried scallop, something different. I want to do a fried scallop chip. Then we're going to do some jerk chicken with some sweet potatoes. We'll be back in a second. Okay, here we go. Now, we have some nice scallops here. What I've done, you take them and you hold them on edge. Come in here and just go ahead and slice thin. And you can get you three, and if the scallops are big, you'll get four slices. And then actually what we're gonna do, I have some here soaking in a jerk seasoning, which I have some chicken marinating in that also. And we're gonna deep fry some, and we're gonna also do a little pan saute with them. And great for an appetizer in a restaurant. Just take these out and make some nice chips with them. Great to do. We're getting our grease ready. I'm gonna chunk these in here, marinate them a little more, and then we'll get ready and we'll be heading on into the mix as far as for on the grill. Here we're just gonna season these. Just mix them up. You can use your seasoning. I mean, if you like Old Bay or whatever is available there, go ahead and do it. And then I just use a little bit of milk, just a little cream or buttermilk on here. And then I come in a dry batter and we go right into the grease. Back here we have these there, marinated goodness Caribbean sauce. We'll come here. I got my skillet heating up. And these just take just a second. I mean, all you're doing is just searing them real easy on both sides and then ready to eat, man. I mean, you could eat them raw if you really want to. Come in here. Pan could have been just a little hotter, but it's gonna work. It's a real quick dish. Done. This will take just a bit of a second and we'll just flip them over. And that heat up. Here we go, we're gonna flip them. All you do is flip once because it doesn't, it basically almost cooks. What I like to do is maybe come back with just a a little small season on this side. Pretty far off. Let me just come up here. Set them up. And then we'll come back and we'll fry the other ones, and then we'll have a little tasting going on. But you imagine, like, this is three scallops, and look, the servings you'll get out of three. So it's a good presentation, and it stretches out a long ways. Okay, we'll get ready to fry. We're gonna just do a little light batter on them, toss them in this. Of course, that's my mix, but you know, we can get this. We can ship if you'd like, you know, we can ship it out to you. Both products, the seasoned mix, the fry mix and the seasoning, really both. And then we also have hats. We got a little bit of, I'll send you an old shoe if that's what you really like, you know. Here we go, let's go try this out. Oh, it should be good and hot. Not quite. Well, yeah, we're there. Now these are just really quick. Probably about a minute at the most. Get them in here real quick. My favorite, man. I love Cajun food, but I love me some Jamaican. Or Caribbean. I'm all into that, you know. I spend a lot of time down there when I get on cruises, and it's for me to do. I love it. We'll be back in a second. All right, here we go. Been in about a minute. You just want them to just get a little crispy on them. Bring them out. All right, we have them out. We put a little light seasoning over the top, and then we'll go ahead and set up our plate. And then we'll show you a little presentation with them. Take care. All right, we got the ribs. We got the chicken out, the jerk chicken. And what I'm doing, I'm spreading a little pepper jelly over them. And really, really, this is I would say Caribbean, Cajun jerk type deal. But, and you glaze these over the top. It's really, really a good, good mix. So we'll set up the plate and then we'll come back and talk about it. Okay, here we go. We had this chicken marinating in this Jamaican seasoning. We did it overnight. And then for time, you know, we had to move it along. But here's our Jamaican jerk chicken. It's finished. Of course, we have a little sweet potato with butter and cinnamon. They love the sweet potatoes there. And then here's our little Jamaican scallops, fried scallops. And listen, anything you need to know, get in touch with me over here at Sweet Peas down in Mir, Louisiana. Jamming it up with Marla tonight. Have a good one.
Get up, stand up. Oh no! Oh no, you did not! Oh, you son of a bitch. Alright, I'm on it. I'm on it. I'm on it. Stand up for your right. I am on it. See, like, how on it I am now? Damn, my phone froze, so I have my low thing. Last week or 2 weeks ago, my phone froze, and it shut down the whole entire thing. So I'm feeling very proud of myself that I had the backup. But I got to get my phone back up because I was just going to lead right into Nipple Man. But I can't do that with this. It's too hard to explain. So, oh my God, there's burp number two. Somebody was asking about tipping before. If you want to tip in the write-up of the thing, there's a Venmo or PayPal, but I really don't care about that. What are you guys eating? Since we got Sweet Pea in the house, what are you guys eating? Hmm? I want to hear some of it. What you got, Gephardt? Hmm? I don't need tips. I just need a like rally. It's a like rally. I want to know what you're eating. What are you eating? Cookie dough. Sheila. I bet they have really good cookie dough in Jamaica, though. All right, Debbie Salmon. Oh, I gotta get down there. It's Boswick's, right? They're doing a drive-in, right? Burp lady. That's too funny. Ribs, thank you. You have a little Jamaican seasoning on that? Not Jamaican, all right. Hold on, I'm trying to do two things at once here. What else? Strawberry margarita, that's kind of Jamaican. I'll take it. Yes, I'm gonna trust this Camille. Bistec and artichokes. Oh my God, you're having hooked open today. How do you do the Venmos in the write-up of the show? Hold on a second. Ceviche. Thank you, Lynn's Hula Hut. That is very appropriate for a Jamaican-themed party. Okay. I think I'm back on my other phone. Hold on, which means that I can go into Nipple Man. Let me hook it up. Live from Hot Mess Studios in a basement in Montauk. Let's see. Hold on. Let's see if I'm back. Let's see if I'm back. Am I back? I am back! I am back! And I am celebrating with Nipple Man. That's what I am celebrating with. Where do we even go first? Let's take a vote. Do we do Nip? You know what? I quite like the Nipple Man drumming. Nipple Man drumming is quite good. Nipple Man drumming. Nothing says Jamaica like Nipple Man with a timbale. What is that? So good. You see that right up there? That's the chick that's hooking me up with these Nipple Man combos. Ashley Gardner, man. She is so good. It takes a lot to make me laugh, like, out loud. And I have to say, every single time I get Nipple Man, I laugh. And I know that I wanted to follow up Lynn with Nipple Man because I just felt that we were having a sexual revolution with that. But I couldn't because my phone froze. But I'm going to do a double hit on Nipple Man right now. And I'm going to hit you with Nipple Man number two. It's Nipple Man as a pirate. It just never gets old. And when the economy comes bounding back, Ashley will have a Nipple Man book. And we will never tell the man that posed as Nipple Man. We will just reap in tons of money because I have done enough art in my life for free that I feel that Nipple Man posed once and that bitch is gonna, we're gonna ride it out. Hold on. That is so funny. Hold on, I'm so sorry. That is so funny. I can't get enough. Hold on, a little reggae, come on. Come on, come on. Do you feel it? Come on. Little darling, steer it up. All right. We have a new addition. Georgia Warner wrote this beautiful song about staying inside. She is the daughter of Bridget Leroy, but a well-known actress in her own right, and quite a voice and quite a presence. So let's enjoy her original tune.
The freedom is always freer in some other U.S. state. You used to just run right out there. Now that'd be a huge mistake. Just look around New York City, so sick with COVID-19. I've heard that it's pretty shitty, so why don't we quarantine? Whoa, just stay inside. Just stay inside. Darling, it's better when you're less deader, so stay alive. Some folks still got to take the train, but if you don't, then don't complain. If you ain't essential, stay residential. Just stay inside. Inside you can stay real healthy, can still touch your eyes and nose. The people outside ain't healthy, they sick cause they've been exposed. And being exposed is sucky, for high risk especially. But Trump, he don't give a fuck, he don't got any empathy. So just stay inside, just stay inside. inside. If you got mateys in their late 80s, help them survive. When you get that cabin fever curse, remember a COVID fever's worse. Don't get all shivery, order delivery, just stay inside. Just stay inside. Cuomo keeps asking, send us more masks, and he gets denied. Even the surgeon and the docs, they get the surgeon start to cough. They get infected, we stay protected, just stay inside. There's pets you can pet, there's posts you can post, there's drinks you can drink, and we got the most. There's reading to read and TV to see, can binge Tiger King all day. There's snacks you can stack and cakes you can bake, TikToks you can watch if you need a break. There's men you can swipe or friends you can Skype, create a one-man play!
I mean, she's giving the goats a run for the money. She is giving the goats a run for the money. That was fucking awesome. Okay, so Georgia, I'm confused. I want to know. I know that's the Little Mermaid song, but did you take the lyrics to that, or did somebody, was that just your interpretation of a song that somebody else had written? That was phenomenal. And I don't know what my favorite part was, because I really loved your voice. You're stunningly beautiful, but I really, really love the still going. And then the little bit of snow. That was good. That was good stuff. That was good stuff. All right. Listen, we're going to get to Richard. We have so much. We have Janet O'Brien still. Oh, look, there's been a like rally. Georgia started a like rally. She started a light rally. You wrote all the lyrics. That was insanely, amazingly awesome. That was insanely. I can see why your mother. And you know what? Bridget, you get to be proud, because she really does shit stars. I mean, all parents, let's just be honest. One of the best advice I heard is that, oh, look, that's pretty. Is that you're not truly a parent until you think your child shits stars. But in this case, your child actually does shit stars. She is that good. She is as good as you think she is. That is how good she is. That was awesome. I'm going to watch that again. And you know, I can watch that again, because all of these broadcasts stay on this channel. So when you're having a really crappy day and you want to make corn nuts, you can rewind it. Although, I am hoping that Inda's going to have her. I'm sure she's going to have her own thing. In fact, we met over a show that she was doing long ago, many years ago, with musicians and food. this one kind of came together, but she is a real, real cook, so I'm looking forward to that. All right, ladies and gentlemen, before we get to Richard and to Kate and to Janet and to astrology, we're going to have a little bit of fun. This was an idea that popped into my head on Tuesday night. And yes, here we go.
Y'all, it's Bucky Peterson here for another round of the COVID-19 dating game. Here we connect people virtually amidst the COVID-19 pandemic. Things are getting pretty lonely. This week, our bachelor hails from Louisville, Kentucky. Please welcome John Jameson. All right, John, let's meet them bachelorettes. Contestant number one comes from California. She's Brittany. A smooth, deep voice with a penchant for braiding. Contestant number two is a real bronco of a gal. From Wisconsin, it's Karen. And the last but not least, from the east end of Long Island, we have a second-tier superhero, Clam Lady. Say hello.
Hello, ladies. I'm from Kentucky. I'm John. So let's start off by each of you telling me something about yourselves. Let's start off with number three and work the other way back.
Hey, John. I'm Clam Lady, and I'm from the east end of Long Island. And I'm looking for somebody that is totally hands-on and not afraid of seagulls.
Hi, I'm Karen. I come from the Midwest. I love horses, Marlboro Reds, and tying up very large men with mommy issues.
Hi, I'm Brittany from California, and I really like puppies, vanilla-scented candles, and twirling around my house aimlessly.
All right, ladies, let's jump right in. Contestant number two, what are you looking for in a man?
I'm looking for a man with very big feet. All right? I don't care about anything else. I don't care if he's got money. I don't care if he's nice. I got earplugs for that bullshit. I just need man with big feet. You know what I'm saying, John? Big feet. And a gun. Big feet and a gun. That's what I want. John.
Contestant number three.
I don't know, John. I hope you have a good sense of humor. I hope you have a good laugh, too. I hope you don't have an annoying laugh. John.
I got you, girl. How about you, contestant number one?
What I'm looking for in a man is I'm looking for a man who's confident in themselves, respects their parents, and really likes a beaver that needs a barber.
Contestant number one, I love beavers too. So let's roll with that. Number one, what do you think sets you apart from the others?
What sets me apart, according to my therapist, is my inability to grasp reality.
All right, all right. How about you, number two? What sets you apart?
I'm listening to these two, and what sets me apart is that I haven't had a guy in 10 weeks. So if you pick me, sweetheart, I'm going to wrap these lips around your and I swear to God, I'm going to... The chrome is going to come off. And then I can't even explain to you. I'm going to the bedpost and I'm going to make sweet, sweet love.
Ooh, I don't want you to stop talking. Is there anything else that sets you apart, dear? I'm intrigued.
What sets me apart is my just ability not to love. I don't want to fall in love. I just need to get pounded. That's all I need. You don't even have to take out the fucking trash. Just come to my farm and hook this lady up, John. Please. I can't watch Ryan Seacrest anymore. It's getting to me.
A contestant number three.
I can shave my legs with a clamshell in front. Does that turn you on? Does that work for you?
No, darling. I think a number two's got you beat.
Does that no? Okay. Never mind. I can catch a striped bass with my bare hands.
A contestant number three. And you say you got a East Coast. You're an East Coast girl. But you got some kind of New York City, Brooklyn type of accent. So what's going on with that?
Actually, John, I talk like this. But the problem is when you're a superhero, that if you say tally-ho, can you just move along or can you put a mask on? They don't really respond the same way as, hey, yo, put your mask on or something like that. So that's why I talk this way. But if we're together and we've had a lovely night, it's... Darling, would you like some French toast for breakfast?
So now you're from Long Island with an English accent? Whatever.
Great.
I think I finally made my decision, but contestant number one, one question. What would be your perfect date, number one?
What's my perfect date? Well, I know a lot of people say April 24th because it's not too hot and it's not too cold and all you might need is a light jacket, but I prefer it a little bit warmer, so I'll say May 5th.
Ooh, those are some pretty gals. So, John, which one's it gonna be?
Tough decision. All these ladies are fine ladies, but for me, it's an obvious choice. I'm going with contestant number two. Can't wait to be with you.
I feel like I want to find out who Nipple Man really is. And I think it would only let me down because I've built up a real relationship in my head with him. But could you imagine, like, you know, if we actually found out who he was and they were like, hey, and he was like, what's up, you know? Listen, that skit was put together in 48 hours, so it obviously had some editing issues, but can we have a toast to Richard, who recorded that, like, yesterday night at 6 o'clock, and I had a third character who was from California, and she just wasn't funny, and it wasn't working, and I was like, you know, it was like, you have these things in your head sometimes, And so I said, I literally texted him and I was like, Richard, I have this skit and I've done all these parts and I'm putting it together and it's not working and I need you. And within 45 minutes, I was like, could you be Brittany from California? I think that's what set him off. Cheers to you, Richard. You know what? Let's hit ourselves with a little Richard Holub hair. How's everyone doing? All right? Give me some love. Everyone doing all right? Anybody need a little extra love?
If you need a little extra love, you write, I need a little extra love, and I'll give you a little extra love. You doing all right, Yvette? Inda, you doing all right? Richard is always amazing. He's a born star. I know. All I have to say is Brittany. I could be like, Richard, could you come over to my house and fold laundry as Brittany? And you'd be like, sure, Nance. No problem. I'll bring my mask. All right, let's hook us up with some Richard. Come on. And then we're going to go to, we're going to have some Tracy Moore astrology, bitches. We are on fire.
Hey guys, Richard Hollop here. So instead of doing a hair tutorial today, I'm going to answer some questions sent to me by you guys. And these are questions that have been sent to me since we've been home. And they're also the most common questions I get asked when we're at the salon. So let's begin. How do I prevent a next day's rat's nest? Brush your hair. Yeah, if you have your hair up in a bun for 5 days and you take the elastic out and you're wondering why it's still up in a bun, it's because you haven't brushed it. So trust me, brush your hair. Help, I have a stench coming from my hair. Ew, wash your hair. Like, you know, any other time I'd be like, okay, like you have an overactive sebum gland or something of that nature and you need to go see a dermatologist, but because you sent me this question right now, I'm guessing that you haven't washed your hair. So wash your hair. You're nasty. Go wash your hair. Do I have to get my split ends cut? No, you don't have to do anything you don't want to. But if you want them gone, yeah, you have to get them cut. I know there's all these products on the market right now that say split end sealer, split end fixer, split end Band-Aid, I mean, whatever they say, and guess what? They are not telling you the truth. They're just like the girl in the box dye. They're lying to you. They're all liars. Oh, box dye girl, that reminds me. So you didn't listen to me. You went, you did the box dye thing, and your hair came out too dark. So we're going to have a little color 101 demonstration here. The black Sharpie is going to represent the dark color on your hair. Okay, and then because you didn't learn your lesson enough the first time, you go back and you get a lighter color, and that's gonna be the highlighter. So you put the lighter color over the darker color, you wash it out. Well, what the hell, it didn't work. When you put a highlighter over a Sharpie, does it show up? No, it doesn't show up. So that is color 101, my friends. Leave it to us, hang in there. The professionals will take care of it when we can. But don't do anything else, please. Just let it be. The best thing you can do is deep condition it. If you don't have deep conditioner at home, use olive oil. You're gonna look like one of those prepubescent kids with an overactive oil gland, and you're gonna look greasy, and you're gonna look gross. But you know what? You're home anyway. Put it on your hair, leave it in all day, shampoo it out at night, or go to sleep with it. I don't like to do that, but I like my sheets too much. Call me crazy. You know, really kind of put as much moisture back into your hair as you can right now. Another good one is when the people come to me and they ask me for a certain number of layers. So she comes in and she's like, hi, I want like 3 layers. I'm like, okay, well, 3 layers. If I can see your layer like one of those blocks out of a Tetris game, then your last hairstylist was not doing it right. The layers should all blend in seamlessly and you shouldn't be able to see them at all. Also, when you come in and you show me a picture, so many of you say, oh my God, it must be so annoying when I show you a picture. It's actually not. I like a good photo reference of what people want. It helps me guide you to where you want to be. But if you have fine wispy hair and you show me a photo of Beyonce, I'm going to probably laugh a little bit and be like, I can't give you that hair. You know, that's not your hair. That's not even her hair. It's a weave. So, you know, just bring in photos. Now's the perfect time to start like a hair Pinterest board, hair inspiration board, but just try to keep it realistic and some sort of in the realm of what kind of hair you have or what we can, you know, bring your hair to possibly be. That's all of the questions that I have from you guys, but feel free to send me more. You can always DM me on Instagram, holub_Richard. Look me up on Facebook. I'm more than happy to answer your hair questions or any of your hair troubles right now. So I hope everybody's well. I will see you all soon. Take care.
Okay, I have now gotten to the place where I never know if he's going to really give advice, or I was like, is a penis going to come shooting out of something? I just did not know. Love you, Richard. It was real advice from a real hairdresser because he's amazing. And he's at the salon in Amagansett, which is where I have gone for years, which, you know, I'm going to say something. Because I've gone for years, I think it's growing out pretty well right now. You know, I got to say, it's dark. And yeah, there's a little zebra, but I'm just saying, Annie, you know, I love Richard, I do. Annie has been my stylist, so I have to give her props. And I know she's been my stylist for 19 years, because here's my little hair story. Hold on, let me get some reggae music pumping. I, of course, didn't have money, and I was a waitress, and I started going out with my husband, and my hair had been dyed so many times from L'Oreal that it was literally snapping here, and it felt like Brillo. And so he would like go to make out with me, and I'd be like, oh, this is a, don't touch the hair, because it was like straw. So I went in, I bit the bullet, I picked up an extra waitressing shift, and I have soft hair 19 years later. All right, everybody, we're gonna keep rolling along, rolling, rolling, rolling. We have some really good stuff. Listen, one of my dearest friends, Janet O'Brien, is still in Peru right now. She's been there for a while. And so she's such a phenomenal chef. And I said, could you just show us a little something? And she said, yes, I do a Caribbean ceviche. So she sent me this from Peru a few days ago. This is Janet O'Brien, world-renowned caterer of Janet O'Brien Caterers.
Project, hi from Peru, quarantine, 2 months, have you missed me? Janet O'Brien, gonna talk about ceviche for a moment, okay? Caribbean style. So Caribbean style ceviche, you get some coconut milk in there to go with your rum punch. So here we have, get to Montauk, get a piece of fluke, chop it up, get the juice of maybe eight limes in there. Just the juice with the diced fluke. Some delicious spicy pepper, our jalapeno pepper, a little dice. Then of course our favorite green, a bunch of cilantro. Dice it in there, more pepper. Let it sit for no more than 10 minutes with the juice. It's gonna cook that diced fluke to perfection. Finish with a little bit of the most wonderful coconut milk and get that rum punch going. All right, Nancy Atlas project tonight. Wonderful, love you guys, miss you.
All right, I'm taking Nipple Man to the market now because she was in the market. And thank you, JJ. I know you're watching from Peru right now. Get home safe. I know you're coming home soon. I don't know exactly. I think she's, I don't know exactly where she is in Peru, so I don't want to say. But this is Nipple Man in the market. Sorry, guys. I know. I know it hurts, but, you know, and I'm really not one of those chicks, but I guess I am when I got a show. You get to see guys with nipples all night long. Oh, God. I'm rolling right along because I got so much love in the house today. So much love. All right, so some people needed some extra love. Lauren, love you. You know, Kevin Prejean, who doesn't love Sweepy? Big love. Thank you. You've given us so much love every week. We get to come together and see your creations. I mean, damn, I never even thought of a scallop chip. And it's weird right now because it's like we're missing that touch of our friends. We're missing that outside touch. You know, we always have our family, and it's a beautiful thing, and people we know, but, and so I think it's okay to just reach out for it and say, I can use some extra love. So I definitely needed some love this week. You know what my epiphany was this week? My epiphany was, holy shit, I completely understand why women in the 1950s had nervous breakdowns and drank a lot. That's all I'm going to say. All right. You know what? We need some good positive energy. It's time for astrology with Tracy Moore. Hello, everybody. Tracy Moore here, giving you your astrology news for the weekend of May 15th through 17th. So, let me just preface something and tell you that astrology has been around since 1800 BC. It's a science. It's incredibly accurate. It's not as woo-woo and, you know, out there as people make it seem. It's based on sacred geometry. It's also based on the energy that the cosmos gives us, right? So we say in astrology, as above, so below, right? So there's a direct connection with the field of energy around us and the heavens above us. So I had to get that one out of the way. So this weekend, we have a moon in Pisces. Ah, the moon in Pisces. Sensitive, intuitive, imaginative, super psychic, right? So this moon happens to be holding hands with its ruling planet, which is Neptune. And when Pisces and Neptune are together, there tends to be a overabundance of emotional sensitivity, right? So if you're feeling like you're gonna cry for no reason this weekend, allow that to happen, right? This also is a very intuitive and psychic energy. So for those of you that have some psychic ability, you may find that is manifesting a little bit for you this weekend as well. So trust your intuition and know that this moon also is, when a moon is in Pisces and it's next door to its ruling planet, Neptune, it can also bring out the addict in you, right? So for those of you that have some addiction issues, you like to do a little and a little. You may want to just take a little look at that this weekend and try not to overindulge, because the feeling of wanting to escape may happen for you. So just a little heads up with that. I also want to tell you to be very mindful of your dreams this weekend, because a Pisces moon has very vivid dreams. And if you have some kind of a message coming through during those dreams, jot them down, take a look at it. There may very well be a message for you. So that's my moon in Pisces. I also wanted to talk to you a little bit about a planet called Venus, which happens to be in retrograde today, right? It's moving backward. So when a planet is in retrograde, it kind of goes and reverses itself and slows everything down. Venus is the planet that rules romance and love and all things beautiful. It also rules luxury items. So don't get on that internet and start buying expensive shit, because you're gonna live to regret it. Don't buy the boat. Do not buy the boat until the end of June. Promise me that, right? You're gonna live to regret an expensive purchase the next month. Venus also happens to be in the sign of Gemini right now, which is rules communication and how we chat with people. And when Venus is in Gemini, you may find yourself reviewing how you talk with people in your life, particularly your loved ones. So this is a great time to review, how am I communicating with my man or my woman? How am I communicating with my kids? How am I communicating with the people that I love in my life? So good time to reevaluate that. And it's also, reading my notes, I have to, because there's so little time and so much to say. This is another important point with that Venus in Gemini. This is a time that you may start to think about how other people see you.
So it's like a reflective time for you to kind of review how other people view you and how you view other people. So you can make some good changes when it comes to the way that you speak with people, and be mindful again of that emotional energy of the Pisces moon. Could be a beautiful, sensitive, wonderful time. And I wish you all love and Godspeed, and I'll see you all around the cosmos.
I don't know if I'm in time, and I don't really care. I mean, like, you know, there's a latency thing. How much do you love that astrology? Damn it, I love that astrology! I look forward to it. That's how I know what to give to you. If I'm looking forward to it, I think you're looking forward to it. Like this man right here. So, I was talking to Tracy about what she was just talking about, because I've had an issue with, oh my God, really? I've had an issue with this camera, and it's my, whatever, I don't need to go into it. But she said the reason that you're not buying anything right now, it's not forever, it's just until June, I think she said 26th, because everything's in retrograde, and it will break. You'll get lemons. That's what it, and I swear, now, I'm almost 50 years old. I have gone through periods where everything has broken, where I didn't know the astrology of it. And Mike Maz would say, you're in retrograde. We're in retrograde right now. And I'd be like, no way. And I've had shows where things have truly busted. I mean, I think it's a cross between Ghosts of the Talk House. Oh, June 25th. Okay. All right, Trace, what is the deal? Because I've been having dreams of fires. I had a crazy fire dream. Don't buy the boat. Buy the boat after June 25th. Because the point is, you're going to get the shitty boat. That's, I think, what you were saying before. You're going to get the boat. The energy of the boat is, it's not a good time to buy big purchases. That's what she was saying. And when she was saying, don't cave into your indulgent qualities. I don't know about any of you guys. I really don't. God bless you if you've been exercising. I really do think that. But my mind has gone to mush. My entire, I was a very consistent person before all of this happened, actually. I went to the gym. I was at the gym 3 to 5 days a week. I would do an hour, then I'd go, because I have 3 kids that are now in school. And I'll tell you, once this hit, it's out the window. And beer every night. I've never drank so much in my life. Not bad, just 1 or 2, but holy mother. So I just wanted to say that in case there's anybody out there that's going through the same thing. I'm right there with you. It's not something I'm proud of not doing or proud of doing or whatever. I feel that when the weather comes, and also feel that when the energy is right, it will come. And you know what? That leads me into something else, which is that it has been a lot. It has been a lot. And you know, I have promised you I'm always going to try to keep the energy up here on Friday night and not be Debbie Downer. But I think we all intuitively know what we can and cannot take. And so I'm just reminding you, because I remind myself all the time, be good to yourself right now. You need to be good to yourself, because it starts with you and then trickles down to everybody else. And so I've definitely tried to let things go. In fact, Ellen, who's lefty on this, was saying something. There's a lot going. There's work with this live feed. And I've said, no, I refuse to be stressed to, like, you know, the normal level during a pandemic. It just let it go. You know what I mean? If it doesn't happen, it doesn't happen. This might be one of my favorite nipple men. I don't know. This is gonna how the book's gonna open, I think. Oh, sing it, Bob.
Can we watch a little Bob? I have some Bob. Give me a little flurry. Do we have anybody left that has that hasn't liked it yet? Can we flurry? Jesse, you were the fart at the end of the last show. No, you weren't telling me to be stressed, Ellen. You were probably reminding me to do something that I have forgotten to do, and I was just saying, no, I can't do it. No, you were being a good friend if you were doing anything. Yeah, it is good. You know what? Let's get arrested. And I have my own little process that I shouldn't really be broadcasting because this is up on YouTube forever. So let's get arrested and take a trip with the king. He died at 47, I believe, of cancer, and left this earth with a lot of good stuff. I've also included a little of one of my favorite interviews. So this one's going to be about 10 minutes. Sit back, relax. Let's chat in the comments, all right? How you doing, guys? You enjoying this show? Making me crazy, baby. Lighten up yourself and don't be no drag. Lighten up yourself, for reggae is another bag. Lighten up yourself.
Traditional culture to be the rest of the killers. You have to do good before you can be arrested.
You have to do good.
If he's bad, then you're bad. If he's good, then you're good.
What would I have to do to be a Rastafari?
Well, the first thing you have to be born again.
Born again?
Yeah. Mankind get lost again because, I don't know, mankind get lost somewhere down the line. Like them don't really, man become enemy. You know, the consciousness that Noah is our father, it come like it don't mean anything to people. Mm. but it means a great deal to the Rasta man, because he knows that is the truth. And that's why him say love, and that's why him overstand everything. You know, that's one of the little part about the unification of the people.
I love reggae music. I do. It's probably one of the go-to musics that I have for, like, when I'm on my boat, if I'm having a day off. Just so damn good. All right. So, I asked this before, but my comments were scrolled back, and I'm sorry if I miss this. Does anybody know what fire dreams are about? I mean, I would say the obvious is that the house is burning down. And I know there was a big fire in Montague. I'm putting my lipstick on because I don't care. And Brian, I'm sure you have fire dreams all the time because you're a fireman. But it was weird. It was weird. It was intense and it was weird. No, not a fan of Steely Dan. I am not a Steely Dan fan. You know why? I'm going to tell you why. He has that fucking song about Uncle Dupree. Why not give a kiss to your Uncle Dupree? What the fuck is that about? Dude, what are you... That's creepy shit right there. And it's in a song. It's not even like Michael Jackson who, like, okay, after the fact you can look. That shit's laid all out right in the second verse. It's like, dude, you have the hots for your niece and your... Okay, wait. They are not about trans men. Sorry, I didn't mean to yell. Okay, hold on. Wait. Okay, hold on. Oh, I missed what she said. Okay, I'll ask you later. What do spiders in your dream mean? Oh, spiders are good. Spiders are for writing. I'm sorry I'm touching my eyes so much. They're watering. Spiders are for writing. That I know. Because you're going to write something. I missed it again. What the fuck do the fires mean? Oh my god. The fire is about riding in... About riding the old, burning the past, transforming. Wow. So I guess that have nothing to do with having a live stream from my basement when I used to play on a stage for 25 years. Guess that has nothing to do with that. That couldn't be what's burning. What could that be? riding the old. The only thing I'm riding right now is my laundry pile. That's the only thing I'm riding. Freaking Karen from Wisconsin, man. I need to get my Karen on. Riding. Okay. Karen from COVID. We had a special ridding. Stop yelling at me. We had a message from Haley. I did not get it in the sequence thing, but she will be coming back. She has a lot going on, but she misses everyone. And we're such a huge fan of Haley and of everyone. Stop yelling at me. Okay, what's I have a good dream one. I was gonna say, what's the craziest thing? So are we doing potato salad classic rock? Or can we amend that? Chris and No Ding, you've come up. Blues Brews and Barbecues was really good, and I know it's close to that. But it is next week's gonna be a little hectic for me. Just a heads up, I am doing ridding! I am doing my first two different ones. I'm doing a Zoom private event, and I'm also doing a live feed broadcast from the Talk House with Cliff Black on Thursday. So next week's show, there's a good chance it'll be a little bit shorter, but it's going to be a busy week. So on Thursday, you can check out the Talk House website. They'll have the information for that. It'll be acoustic. It'll just be Cliff and I, but we're going to get the ball rolling. The Talk House is an amazing institution, and you can call it many different things. You can call it a brand. You can call it whatever. But to me, the Talk House will always be family. And so it seems right that Cliff would start it out. Cliff and I would be, and of course, Inda and Gene and everybody else are... We're all figuring it out as we go. So that's something to look forward to. Oh, we got a little whiff of a like there. Somebody whiffed a like. What was I going to say? Oh, there's going to be three people in the entire Talk House, just so anybody that might be thinking that, having some justified concern, there will be... The sound man. No, I'm sorry, that's a lie. There'll be four. It'll be Cliff, myself, the sound man, and the guy that's filming. So, Americana and apple pie. Gephardt. That's good. That's good. I got to think of the poster, you know? Can we just say Americana? Can we just say that? I'm figuring, how am I going to get all apple pie that's like jabba jubba jizzy jazzy, you know? What else can we talk about? What else can we talk about? It's Memorial Day. That's right. That is correct. It is Memorial Day next weekend. A cold Memorial Day at that. But look at us right now. You know, honestly, look at us together as a community, even here tonight, coming together. And, you know, it's always a conflicted feeling about... I want to see these live broadcasts do well so that I can eventually build them up with sponsorship. But if I'm really, really being honest right now, I really love that it's us right now and that we can just talk and that we can just be together. Americana, thanks, Eaton. That's apple pie skit. From American Pie. Okay, so what am I gonna go to jail for next week? The apple pie skit from American Pie. Let me write that down. Apple pie skit. Red, white, and brew. Fuck, that's good. Red, white, and brew. That's so Memorial Day. We going back to the beer? Yes. Richard, can you reenact it and just not give us any hair tips next week? I just want to tell you that we have a really awesome, amazing reading still from Kate Muth. But I want to just catch up with you guys and Josh Gladstone. They did something really phenomenal and incredible, and I'm gonna I'm going to definitely, but I want to chat right now. I'm in a chitty chat mood. Oh my gosh, Richard, would you do that for next week? That would be so good. I'm going to sing the national anthem next week. I am. And I'll think about what else that I can pull together. It's going to be pretty interesting. It's going to be an interesting week for sure. Is it going to snow this week? It's so freaking cold still. All right. So this is so cool. Let me fade out of the music there. So how many art forms do we have? We have so many art forms. I love that Nibble Man is just hanging out. Hold on. I'm bringing it real. So let me go back to Tropical Paradise. Okay. We have a thriving, albeit, what's the word? We're not starving, we're hustling. We have an incredible artistic community out here. Our painters, I always say, what a time to be alive. Every generation has had them, right? So if you're in the East End of Long Island, you're out going to shows, you're seeing Dalton Portella, you're seeing Patton Miller, you're seeing Randy Rosenthal, you're seeing all of these amazing, amazing artists. And then you have people like Kate Muth and Josh Gladstone, who, when they're not running the world artistically from an acting standpoint, I mean, Kate puts on these massive productions. Josh ran Guildhall and produced so many shows, amazing shows. They are two of probably the finest actors we have out here. So she's been very, very busy, and I kind of said, look, we have this platform and it's family, and if you feel really inspired to do something, you should do it and send it to me. And so she sent this to me this morning, and it's just such a treat to be able to play it. How many people are left here with this? 50 of us, okay? And we get to watch this reading that they read. It's a Sam Shepard, a scene from a Sam Shepard play. It's called Fool of Love, I think. And they read it 20 years ago, and they pulled it out, and they read it and recorded it and sent it to me today. So let's check it out, and let's get a little cultured, shall we, while we're in the basement in Montauk.
Action.
May, I'm not going anywhere. Look, see, I'm right here. I'm not gone. I don't know why you won't just look at me. You know it's me, or who do you think it is? You want some water or something? May, huh? Come on, you can't just sit here like this. How long have you been sitting here anyway? You want me to go outside and get you something, some potato chips or something? I'm not gonna leave. Don't worry, I'm not gonna leave. I'm staying right here. I already told you that. May, let go, honey. Okay. I'll put you back in bed, okay? Come on. I'll put you in bed and make you some hot tea or something. You want some tea with lemon? Ovaltine? May, you gotta let go of me. Come on now, okay? Now just, come on, just sit back and try to relax here. You want me to go?
No.
Well, what do you want then?
You smell.
I smell.
You do.
I've been driving for days.
Your fingers smell.
The horses.
Pussy.
Oh, come on.
They smell like metal.
I'm not going to start all this shit.
Rich pussy.
Oh, very yeah, clean. Sure, yeah.
You know it's true.
I came to see if you were all right.
I don't need you.
Okay, fine.
Don't go! Don't go! Don't go!
What am I going to do? Huh? What am I supposed to do?
You know.
What?
You're going to erase me.
What are you talking?
You're going to erase me or have me erased.
Why would I do that? Are you kidding?
Because I'm in the way.
Oh, don't be stupid.
Oh, I'm smarter than you are and you know it. I can smell your thoughts before you even think of
me. I'm trying to take care of you, all right?
No, you're not. You're just guilty. Gutless and guilty.
Great.
I'm gonna kill her, you know.
Who?
Who?
Oh, don't talk like that.
I am. I'm gonna kill her, and then I'm gonna kill you. Systematically. With sharp knives. Two separate knives. So the blood don't mix. I'm gonna torture her first, though. Not you, I'm just gonna let you have it. Probably in the midst of a kiss or something. Just when you think you've got everything all healed up. Right in the moment when you're sure you've got me buffaloed. That's when you're gonna die.
You know how many miles I went out of my way just to come here and see you? You got any idea?
Nobody asked you to come.
2,480.
Oh, yeah? Where were you? Kathmandu or something?
2,480 miles.
So what?
I missed you. I did. I missed you more than anything. I've missed you my whole life. I kept thinking about you just the whole time that I was driving. I kept seeing you. Sometimes just a part of you.
Which part?
Your neck.
My neck?
Yeah.
You missed my neck?
Yeah, I missed all of you, but your neck. Your neck kept coming up for some reason. I kept crying about your neck.
Crying?
Yeah. Weeping like a little baby. Uncontrollable. It would just start up. And then it would stop and then start all over again. For miles. I couldn't sleep. Cars would pass me on the road. People would stare up at me. My face was all twisted up. I couldn't stop my face.
Was this before or after your little fling with the countess?
There wasn't any countess!
You're a liar!
I took her out to dinner once.
Huh.
Twice.
You were bumping her on a regular basis. Don't give me that shit.
You can believe whatever you want.
I'll believe the truth. It's less confusing.
Huh. I'm taking you back, May.
I'm not going back to that idiot trailer, if that's what you're thinking.
Oh, man. I'm moving it. I got a piece of ground up in Wyoming.
Wyoming. Are you crazy? I'm not moving to Wyoming. What's up there, Marlboro man?
You can't stay here.
Why not? I got a job. I'm a regular citizen here now.
You got a job?
Yeah. What'd you think? I was helpless?
No, I mean... It's...
Wyoming. Are you crazy? I'm not moving to Wyoming. What's up there, Marlboro man?
You can't stay here.
Why not? I got a job. I'm a regular citizen here now.
You got a job?
Yeah. What'd you think? I was helpless.
No, I mean, it's been a long time since you had a job.
I'm a cook.
A cook? You can't even flip an egg.
I'm not talking to you anymore.
Man, I got everything worked out. I've been thinking about this for weeks. I'm going to move the trailer and then build a little pipe corral to keep the horses. And then we'll have a big vegetable garden and some chickens.
I hate maybe. Chickens.
Oh. You'll get used to it.
You're unbelievable.
I'm not letting go of you this time.
You never had a hold of me to begin with. How many times have you done this now, huh?
What?
Suckered me into some dumb little fantasy and then dropped me like a hot rock. How many times has this happened?
Oh, it's no fantasy.
It's all a fantasy.
And I never dropped you, either.
No, you just disappeared.
Well, I'm here now, aren't I?
Oh, well, praise Jesus God.
I'm going to take care of you, May. I am. I'm going to stick with you. No matter what, I promise.
Get out of here.
Well, what'd you have to go and run off for anyway?
Run off me.
Yeah, why couldn't you just stay put? You knew I was coming back to get you.
What do you think it's like sitting in the tin trailer for weeks on end with the wind ripping through it, waiting around for the butane to arrive, hiking down to the laundromat in the rain? You think that's thrilling or something?
I bought you all those magazines.
What magazines?
I bought you all a stack of fashion magazines.
Oh, yeah. I especially like the one with the Countess on the front cover. Oh, that was real cute.
All right.
All right, what? All right, well, where are you going?
I'm just going to get my stuff out of the truck.
Oh.
I'll be right back.
What, are you moving in now or something?
Well, I thought I'd spend the night if that's okay. All right, then I'll just leave, I guess.
Wait.
We're so lucky.
Minutes after day to die from the bottomless pit, but my hand was made strong
by Bravo.
The hand of the Almighty. We forward in this generation.
I loved that. Thank you.
Triumphantly, won't you help to sing?
So talented. And I feel very touched that they would share that with us and that they would do that for for this, you know, little broadcast, and I'm not drunk. I'm not, just in case you're thinking, I'm not. I'm just incredibly moved. And I think I'm a little bit sad. All right. So, won't you hear to sing these songs? May we hope that we get past swimming in this unknown water, and that we're all able to emerge stronger swimmers. My personal wish, and I don't really feel like it's super nice to say, because it's like someone saying, well, I wish that Nancy would blah, 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 but Josh and Kate are both their own dynamos, but Kate Muth is just, she's just a phenomenal writer. And I guess my wish is, among many things, that she finds the time to write. That's my wish for her. Wish me luck this week as I venture into playing in a digital format. And I wish you all love, and I think what Marley said in his interview, unification. Look to your own heart and always know what's true and follow it. And put on the blinders if you feel distracted by it. I'm not telling you that. It's more of a confirmation. You know that already. But it's challenging times, and just whatever your beliefs are right now, stand tall for them, and, you know, keep on keeping on. I'll see you maybe on Thursday at the Talk House. And I think I can't end on this, like, sad. I'm not sad. I'm overwhelmed at how beautiful that was. I'm overwhelmed that people can just take words and read them like that and connect like that. So let's have a little Marley upbeat. Don't rock my boat. There we go. See? Reggae always fixes it. All right, anybody have anything coming up that's going on in their lives that they can share with us that they're looking forward to as we move forward? That was burp number 5. I know Eaton's getting a hasty bake. Indy Eaton's getting a hasty bake, which means just watch out. I think she could have a show with just her and the hasty bake. There I am. I'm just, you know, throwing it out there. Sorry, I'm just reading comments. All right, May 21st, a big Zoom event from the Express News Group. Zooming my life away. Ellen, how do they find out about that? The Express News Group website? Planting my veggie garden this week. Oh, good. Embrace that hair, Annie. Embrace it. 27 East Facebook page. Okay, good. Good to know. As far as the Talk House show, I think it'll be on all platforms. I don't know. I think you'd look great any hair that you want. Starting some social distancing rehearsals with the Barroom Girls. Good. That's good. You know? Just remember, I planted what you gave me today, Richard. Oh, I've done some planting too, and they survived the frost. George is opening at the dock. That's right on the 21st. And Annie, yes, you do have great hair. You just got to make sure that you clip the ends just like me, because we have that thing. But you have that hair that everyone loves, the curly and the straight. Early day in the kitchen. Deb, what's the deal with Boswick's? What are the hours on the weekend? It's a drive-in, right? The food's incredible there, just so you know. They just opened up a drive-in at Boswick's on 3 Mile Harbor, right? Good night. Oh, sorry. Good night, Debbie. You'll see me this week. I'll come by. I keep telling everyone that's doing skits that I'm gonna make them like COVID care packages, you know, with like jam and a sweatshirt or something. And then every week, Wednesday rolls around, I'm like, holy shit, I gotta get some stuff together. Okay, Tukla, no conflict with truckers. It's all right if it's a conflict. All right, good night, Carla. Thank you for tuning in. Good night. The Chowder House. And that's where the pickup is. Okay. I don't know why I thought it was on 3 Mile. I know it used to be on 3 Mile Harbor. Okay. So it's the Chowder House and you drive through. Oh, that's good because it can drive through this. Yeah. I'm sorry. I'm just figuring it out in my head. But it makes sense. They can go right through. Okay, great. You will see me this week for sure. The food is amazing. Oh, thanks for that little whiff of a last like. Appreciate it. I'm going to start saying goodnight to everyone. Yvette, goodnight. Good night, Debbie. Good night, Inda. I think she probably already left. And Corky. Kyle's, we're heading out. We're on the other side. You rest up. Good night, Jean. Oh. Jean, I didn't see you there. I've been whatever. Kyle's, I'm so glad you came out the other side of your head. Good night, Sheila. Thank you. Good night, Chris and Rob. Good night, Annie. Love you too, babe. Good night, Richard. Thank you every week for your amazing contribution. Sneaky, sneaky, Jean. Sneaky, sneaky. You'll be rolling my cables before you know it. Good night, Suzanne Ray. You're cooking. The ones that I've seen are amazing. Good night, Robin Dick. Good night, Rebecca. Good night, Bill Becker. Good night, Kerry. Good night, Sharon. Good night, Colleen. Good night, Jesse. Love you. Listen, have a great week. Good night, Yvette. I love seeing you here week after week. Thank you so much for coming and supporting. Good night, Lefty. Good night, David. Good night, Carol. Good night. Thank you so much for checking in. Rich Silver, I think you're 5 for 5, brother. Thank you so much, everybody. Have a great week. And good night, Nancy, with the great name. And we'll all continue to get through this together. Good night, Bettina Schuler. Happy birthday, Bettina. I'm sorry I didn't see you here. Happy birthday, baby. Mama San, you know you're in my heart. And Ashley, thank you for the amazing graphics. Damn, girl. I am a fan. Good night, Kevin Prejean from Meyer, Louisiana. Good night, Janet from Peru. And good night, everyone. All right? And if it's really getting bad, remember, pop on some Marley. Good night, Peter Zent. Good night, Bill from Florida. Good night, Damaris. If you're watching, I got the hat on backwards. All right. Good night, Chip Sullivan. I love you and I miss you desperately in your pink shirt, baby. All right, I'm feeling it now. I'm coming back. Woo! Good night.